Imagine you live in a polluted city of India. You have a local park. The local park has trees, maybe a small pond. You go there with your kids and you like to walk around. One day the authorities decide that the local park is better off as a green waste-to-energy plant. Actually, this is something that has happened in the city of Delhi, where there's a waste-to-energy plant very close to where people live. Once the plant starts its operations, it starts spewing pollution and people develop respiratory problems. What do you do? A, you try to complain. B, you try to say that it's not in public interest to have something so polluting so close to where people stay. But what if the law doesn't assist you or actively tries to make sure that you cannot lodge a complaint or protest against the impact of a project which comes up near you? Now, the new draft 2020 of the Environmental Impact Assessment Act does away with a lot of core provisions that the earlier 2006 notification had. One of these is that of reporting violations. First of all, let's try to understand what an environmental impact assessment is. An environmental impact assessment, or an EIA, is basically a study of what is going to be the environmental impact of a particular project in a particular location. So over here, we're talking about, for example, the waste to energy plant that is near the houses where people live, where young children, old people live. Now, a project of large magnitude, particular sizes, needs to have an environmental impact assessment so we can understand what we are making before we make it. Proximity to where people stay would be one of the ways to understand the impact. Other impacts would be how many trees would be cut down, whether a wetland would be filled up, any possible impacts on biodiversity. The very logic of an EIA is that an EIA needs to be made before a project is done, because there is no point bemoaning once the trees have been cut or the park has been taken over for a waste to energy plant and the plant is running. But the new draft 2020 has three or four issues which are fundamentally against environmental protection. The first is that it allows for post facto clearances. That means if your waste to energy plant or any kind of large infrastructural project or plant comes up near you illegally without environmental clearances, the new draft says that it is okay for the project proponent to give an application, and within the entire process, the project may get cleared even if it has come up illegally. In short, this is a kind of rewarding of violation, and it is also kind of teaching you how to evade the EIA rather than actually do an EIA properly. The second thing is about violations. So you are living near this large project, you don't like it, you don't like the view, you can't breathe the air, you have a problem on grounds of public interest, for example. You should be able to complain about it as a citizen of this country. However, the new draft 2020 also has a provision which says violations can be made by the project developer himself or herself and by the government. It kind of takes away the space of the citizens, you and me, to actually make a complaint under the EIA Act. The third issue is exemptions for many large industries and for many sectors. For instance, earlier, a 20,000 square meter building, which would be roughly the size of a mall, required scrutiny under the expert appraisal committees. Right now, that has been increased to 150,000 square meters, which would be size of an airport or larger. So essentially, everything below 150,000 square meters does not need to go for expert appraisal scrutiny. This clearly is saying that it's okay to build while not considering impacts on the environment. And you know, this also comes at a time when we are actually having these conversations online, or when we are all suffering from a pandemic, where we've all been thinking about what are our impacts on the earth, and you know, is it okay for us to go on business as usual? In our stimulus packages, theoretically, we want to have sustainable development, which means thinking about what we are making before we make it, which means taking a path of environmental sustainability. But with this kind of SOP being given for building and construction, we are also opening the gate for a lot more emission in a very uncontrolled way. Construction dust and construction transport is a very huge contributor to greenhouse gases, and subsequently to global warming. This is the time when we should be considering going slow or going thoughtfully, at the very least, for these large sectors. Instead, we seem to say that it's okay to build first and regret later. The final thing is that the government gets to decide on what is a strategic interest project, and the Act says that, you know, the government will not reveal what are the reasons for having a strategic impact project. Now imagine, once again, going back to the waste to energy example, because a lot of projects are very close to us. They're not always in faraway forests or on the borders of India. They may be right next to where you are. The center deciding on what is national interest or strategic interest is also a challenge to the federal structure. Recently, the government announced, as part of the stimulus package, the opening of 41 coal mines in India, which is something that the CM of Jharkhand, Mr. Soren, has had a problem with. There is a federal relationship that needs to be honored. Going back to your local park and your local wetland and your local trees, there is no way any act that says is supposed to be for the environment can exempt people from the process of environment, because environment is public trust doctrine. It is about public interest. It is about having a clean and a habitable planet for all of us. Therefore, these are decisions that we need to be part of, and right to life is also the right to clean environment. The EIA draft of 2020 is a regressive document which needs to be seen for what it is. It provides a lot of progress for potentially damaging industry without environmental safeguards to go along with that. Thank you.
To receive instant updates on all videos from The Wire, click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. Pay to support independent journalism. Click the link in the description and choose the amount you want to pay.